Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Winnie and I cover a ton of different videos from college to lifestyle to food and drink to travel. But this video will be going over the top 10 things you should do in Seattle while you're here, whether you're visiting or moving here for work. So the first thing you should do is check out the Space Needle. One, because everyone recognizes it. It's like the landmark tourist attraction for Seattle. It's in all the postcards. Like, you should definitely check it out. Tickets are about $35 for adults, and you'll go all the way up in an elevator to the top, where it's like a rotating glass floor. So for people who are afraid of heights, caution.
Approximately 41 seconds up to the observation deck, where you'll be up at a height of 520 feet out of the Space Needle's total height of 605 feet. That's 184 meters or 60 stories.
But I'm sure it's like a super cool experience to go. It's very thrilling and fun, yeah. They also have like this restaurant or cafe up there, so if you want to enjoy the view as you're rotating, that's also an option. And number two is the Chihuly Gardens of Glass. So that is nearby, which is super close, like literally right next door. So if you plan on hitting a ton of things and manage your time wisely, you could do like literally three things in this area. So the Chihuly Glass Garden Museum is full of like glass blowing sculptures. They're like super big too. Even outdoors, they have more, so I highly recommend going. And if you see on Instagram, a lot of people have the like the flower background, which is like red flowers and orange, and it's like in a greenhouse type of environment. That's where they got the photo from. So definitely go there and check it out. It's super cool to see all these sculptures, and I'll throw in some like photos and videos as well. So you can see, but it's definitely worth it. And I think tickets were about like $37 or so per person. So pretty affordable. Oh, and pro tip, they have a city pass. So you can go to 5 attractions for about $115. So that's like way more of a, I guess, cost effective option. And you can use the pass within 9 days, so you can spread it out, but you have to make your own reservations because they're like timed, but it's super easy to do that online. So you could go to Space Needle, the Chihuly Gardens, you could go on a Argazi cruise, and Woodland Park Zoo, and I think there's one more, but it's not coming to mind, so I will put it up here when I find it, so you can check that out. And if you don't want to do all 5 attractions, you can do like just the 2, Chihuly and the Space Needle, and that in itself, I think it's like $57, so like it's also a bundle too. Okay, so the third thing you should be doing is the MoPop. So right next to both of the 2 attractions I just described is the Museum of Pop Culture, and it's this super shiny museum of like pink, blue, and silver. Thank you. cool to go inside because you get to hear like punk rock music, pop, and I went to this Pearl Jam exhibit with like these little bobblehead life-size figure dolls, and they were super cute, and yeah, it was really nice to see like the Tower of Guitars, and they also had like the history of a guitar, I think different bands, and a cool place to chill. Oh, and surprisingly, I found Blackpink socks there, so if you're a K-pop fan, that's how you can get a souvenir. The next thing I wanted to talk about is Pike Place. So that is also super popular on Instagram, as you might know. Apparently people like to really fish there, like people who work there. So if you're there to see a show and you come at the right time, I think of like seafood, like giant lobsters, giant crabs, oysters, clams, yeah, so much. And it's super fresh, and they don't just like have the seafood from Seattle, it's like from everywhere, so it's like the best of the best quality. They also have a ton of different like flowers and like bouquets. People are selling them for like $10 each, and then it goes up to like $25, $40, and you can get a ton of different variety. I always see a lot of people carrying flowers on their way out, and it's so pretty. And you can just put it in your room and just, like, yeah, look at flowers while you work. nearby that is the Gum Wall. So this is like a debated place with me and my friends. Like, it's kind of like disgusting, but also like cool because it's an art form. But I don't know, people like still add to it, you know, like if it's like fresh gum, like if you just go there, chew some gum, then put it on there, or it's like collected over the years, but it might be both because it's kind of like an autograph or a signature, kind of like the Paris locks where you like leave your mark, but literally. But it's cool to see like a ton of colorful gum on the wall. I think it's just unique because you don't really find that anywhere else. I don't know how sanitary it is, I don't touch anything, but maybe like take some pictures there. Oh, and right nearby is like the selfie museum, so if you love photo shoots and taking cool Instagram pictures, you can also stop by there. See, I'm helping you manage your time. Then nearby, if you're feeling hungry, there's a ton of different shops you could check out, which are like really close to each other. Sometimes the lines might be long, but they move fairly fast, except for the Starbucks one, which is like medium. Like, it's not super slow, but not fast. And I'll probably put this in another video, so you can see more in depth of what the stores look like, what food they have, what I got. But yeah, it would be Pike Place Chowder for the seafood soup or like bisque. I got the salmon chowder. You have the classic one as well. And then La Panière for like macaroons and bread. There was also the Beecher's handmade cheese. And that one had the two of my favorite items there. I've eaten there a couple times now. It's the world's best mac and cheese. I think it was like $7.99 for one small cup. And then there was a salmon mac and cheese, which was like $8.99 for a small cup. So I got like one of each to try. Very good. And you could also like buy the kit to take it home and eat it too. And another thing is, oh yeah, Starbucks. I'll have a whole other vlog about it because to me that was an adventure in itself. The OG Starbucks. And then pierogi, which is like a bread covering filled with a savory or sweet filling. And it's like a sandwich. I don't know. I'll put their definition because it sounds much better than mine. But I got the salmon one and it's pretty good. And if you're looking to buy some like additional salmon, they also have the Totem Smokehouse nearby, so you could buy it for home. Like, they also have salmon jerky, or you could like buy it, yeah, just to consume later. Number six, the Great Wheel. So if anyone is into Ferris wheels or like thrilling rides, or just to get like a nice view of the city. That's what I did. It wasn't like a super long line either. And it's like nearby, there's a ton of different things because it's by the waterfront. So there's also the Seattle Aquarium. So you could check that out for about, I think, $30 for an adult ticket. And then have dinner at the Elliott Bay's Oyster House. So yeah, all these things are like super close together, so you can literally plan a date for everything in one day. Seven, I'm gonna like group a ton of things together because I feel like they can all be done in like a short amount of time, so I'm gonna group them together. So number seven is Olympic Sculpture Park. It's literally a park with like huge sculptures of like art installations, like a huge face of someone or like a red crane. It's more so, I think, just to relax with your friends or family and just sit there, watch the water. Like how you would in Paris if you're sitting by the Seine. I don't think there's like much stuff to do aside from like people watching and watching boats. And then the next thing would be like Seattle Art Museum, which is like a pretty, I think, quick museum to go through. It'd be like 2 hours is enough. But they have a ton of different exhibits and I really enjoyed going through them. There was like a Japanese exhibit, European art, Roman and Greek art. Indian art, African art, yeah, they have a ton of stuff, so definitely check that out. And there is a library in the Seattle, I think it's the Seattle Central Library. It's free. People go there for the viewpoints, I believe, so like on certain days you can go all the way up to the top, which is the 10th floor, and then see like the view of Seattle. Aside from that, the architecture outside the building is pretty cool too. It's kind of unique, like the Mansueto Library at UChicago, so that's also a reason to check it out, take pictures. When I was there, like this model was taking a photo shoot outside of the library, so there you go, another IG opportunity, guys. Eight, you should check out the International District, which is where Chinatown is. There's a lot of like Asian restaurants and grocery stores there, like Japanese, Vietnamese, Thai, Chinese. I went there to check out the store of like Uwajimaya, where they sold a ton of like Japanese snacks and candies and makeup. Like these are like the rare items you would technically find abroad in Asia, but they have it here, so that's why I checked it out. And they also have cute plushies and Kit Kat flavors that are different. So I got this peach flavor that you normally can't find like elsewhere in other stores. There's also Daiso. So I saw on YouTube this girl went to Daiso and bought a lot of cute stuff like a bookmark or a little clear plastic baggie with cartoons of Rila Kuma on it and other characters, and I thought it was super cute, so I went there to check it out. And they did have a ton of like stickers and like bookmarks, stuff like that, like post-it notes, sticky notes with all these characters, and it's super fun. So if you want to like, I guess, stock up on your stationery and get cute stuff to write on, that's a place to go. Thank you. And number 9, Cary Park. So this place is, I feel like it's not as heavily known or advertised, but it's like a viewpoint at the top of a hill in Seattle, where you can see the entire view. So like imagine where the postcards are, which is kind of like a bird's eye view, like far of the entire skyline. That's what it is. So even though I have a rooftop in my building, I feel like it's not the same type of view. At Cary Park, it's like super postcard. I think that's the best I can describe it, actually. Super postcard ready. So definitely check that out. I walked up there, or mini hiked, because the streets are very sloped, like, and steep. So it was kind of like not a super easy walk up there, but definitely doable. It's like 12 minutes if you follow Google Maps, but there's also a bus you can take. It'll take you like right up on that street and then you're there. And finally, number 10, how could I leave out the famous Mount Rainier? A lot of my friends have already hiked Mount Rainier and been up there. I think you could see glaciers or other cool stuff. And I think a tour is like $100 for a day, the guide. That's what I've researched. I have not been up there yet. I'm still trying to get in shape to hike, but maybe one day I will go up there and see what the view is like. These are the top 10 things I suggest you should do in Seattle while you're here. And I will have another vlog or video talking specifically about food and drink. But I hope this was helpful and it got you interested in visiting or potentially moving here. And remember to like my video, comment below which attraction you think is the best or that you want to check out, or if there's any other place that I missed that you think I should go look at, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.